In the present session, I shall discuss some problems on finding the extremals of the given functionals and also the variational problem, how the formulas of Euler's formula and other formulas will be applied in order to find out the extremals of the given functionals. Let me take an example. Find out extremals of the functional integration x1 to x2 x plus y dash multiplied to y dash, it is dx. This is an integration. As we know that the function under the integral sign is called functional, then we select that functional with some notation and then we apply the Euler's formula. Afterwards, we will solve, that will come as a differential equation, and then we will solve that differential equation. And we have the condition that there are two derivatives we have to find out in Euler equation. One is if we indicate this quantity by f, then it should be differentiated with respect to y once, and it should be differentiated with respect to y dash. If with respect to y the value comes to be 0, then we have to take the derivative of the another one, that is del f divided by del y dash is equal to some constant. Let us see how this functional behaves for these two derivatives with respect to the Euler's equation. In the solution, let the given integral that I indicate, that is x1 to x2, should be x plus y dash into y dash, that is dx. This can be taken as, that is x1 to x2 f of x comma y comma y dash, and it is dx. Here we can separate f of x comma y comma y dash, that is equal to x plus of y dash and multiply to y dash. This is what we have. Then after the expansion, that is removal of this bracket, x into y dash plus of y dash square. This is for f of x comma y and it is y dash. Next, we go for Euler's equation by Euler's equation. We have, by Euler's equation, we have del f by del y minus of d bar dx of del f divided by del y dash, that is equal to 0. From the given function, these two differential coefficients we have to calculate, and these two differential coefficients we have to see that if both of them are not 0, then we will get a differential equation and then we have to solve as it is. But if this value comes to be 0, then del f by del, with respect to del f by del y dash is equal to some constant. And from the comparison with the given function, that means that function appears under the integral sign, we can easily make out it is independent of y because no term of y is there. Okay, then del f by del y equal to 0 implies the function, that means functional f of x comma y comma y dash is independent of y. Then del f divided by del y dash is equal to, then you have to differentiate with respect to y dash, x plus of 2 times y dash x plus of 2 times y dash, that is equal to that is the value of del f by del y dash. Then here we consider this y dash is equal to dy by, it is dx. Then we need to solve this one as it is. That means del f by del y dash we need to solve as it is, otherwise anyway this is equal to 0 minus of this much. Okay, so independent of that y, here this value only has to be differentiated, that is del f by to be solved, del f by del y dash is equal to x plus 2 times y dash. So then we have x plus of 2 times y dash is equal to some constant, that is called as c1. Afterwards, x plus of, that is 2 times, should be dy by dx, because in place of y dash, that is equal to constant c1. Then you can have this one, that is x into dx. If you divide throughout by dx, x into dx plus of 2 times dy is equal to c1 into dx. Then integrating, we get first term integration with respect to x, that is x squared divided by 2y equal to, it is c1 into x, and plus so it is c2. That is x square plus so it is 4y is equal to 2 times c1, x plus so 2 times it is c2. Afterwards you can write that c2 as some other constant, that is 2 times c1 and 2 times c2. Let x square plus 4y is equal to a into x plus of b, where we represent these two constants together with another quantity, that is a is equal to 2 times c1 and b is equal to 2 times c2. This implies whatever the function we have calculated, which is the required, which is the required extremal, which is the required extremal for the given functional, for the given functional. Let us try another problem of the same type, how this functional is different from the functional which is appeared in this problem. Let us see how another problem behaves in order to find out the extremal. Another example, okay. Find the extremal of integration 1 by 10 up to 1 y dash into 1 plus x square into y dash, x square into y dash, that is dx. Solution. In this problem, here also we have the functional, that means function under the integral sign is independent of y.
That means when y is not there, then the derivative with respect to y dash will be treated as constant. But the limits are given here. There the limits were x1 to x2, they were unknown values. But here limits are given means we have to find out the constants at the end in the differential equation. Here the initial conditions we can take, that is y at x equal to 1 by 10, this is equal to, values are given, where y at 1 by 10 means x at 1 by 10, this is equal to 19, and y at 1 is equal to 1. These two are the conditions given, and we have to make use of these two conditions. These are not called initial conditions, but they are boundary conditions, because x equal to 1 by 10 and x equal to 1 will be, that is x equal to 1 by 10 at one value of x and x equal to 1 the another value of x. Let us see how this functional behaves in the calculation of that derivatives or the Euler's equation. First of all, let us integrate this one. Let y is equal to integration 1 by 10 lower limit up to 1, that is y dash 1 plus x square into y dash, that is dx, will be taken as f of x comma y dash equal to this function y dash into 1 plus x square, that is y dash will be the functional value. Then by Euler's equation, we have del f by del y minus d by dx del f divided by del y dash equal to 0. Then you find the derivatives with respect to this, but before that you can also release this bracket y dash plus sum x square into, it is y dash square after releasing the bracket. Then let the first derivative, that is del f by del y, del f by del y is equal to 0 implies the functional f of x comma y dash is independent of y. Then del y dash is equal to some constant c1, then we can take the differentiation with respect to y dash, that is equal to y dash with respect to that is 1, and this one x square, this one x square, and we will write that y dash, that is into 2 times, because y dash square is there, and 2 times y dash, that is the differentiation by the second term, that is a derivative with respect to y dash. Then when it is equated to c1, let us take this equation in the form of divide dx, so that here itself let me write 1 plus of x square into, that is 2 times dy by dx, that is in place of y dash. Therefore c1, and taking the cross multiplication, after taking LCM here, then 1 will be multiplied by dx. This implies, that is dx plus 2 times x square, it is dy, and 2 times x square, that is dx is there, equal to c1, that is equal to c1 into should be dx. Then we have to integrate this equation, that is with respect to x, the first term, and with respect to y in the with respect to y in the second term, and right side is also with respect to x because dx is there. Then we can write integrating, we get, that is x plus tau, this must be with respect to y, means it is 2x square y equal to c1, that is x plus tau, it is c2. This is the final form after integrating the value of del f by del y dash from the Euler's equation. Then we need to find out these two constants, because this is not a complete solution. This is a general solution because it includes these two constants. Then to find out the constants in particular, we can make use of the given values. Those given values are, one value is y at 1 by 10 equal to 19, and y at 1 is equal to 1. These are the given conditions. So if any equation contains arbitrary constants, what is the mathematical comparison we make with the number of constants, and it must match with the number of conditions given. Okay, so now two conditions are given, we have two constants, then those two constants can be evaluated by substituting individually. Then at the first constant, that is we can make use of first constant, that is y at 1 by 10 is equal to 19. Therefore this must be y value is equal to 19 at x equal to 1 by 10. And another one, y value equal to 1 at x equal to 1. Those two values I'll do like this. That is at x equal to 1 by 10 and y is equal to 19. So let us write x equal to 1 by 10 and how this equation behaves. Afterwards, another condition we will use, how this equation behaves, so that C1 and C2 we can calculate separately. Then at x equal to 1 by 10, y equal to 19, we have, that is 1 by 10 plus of 2 into 1 by 100, because x equal to 1 by 10 means 10 square I am writing, and y is equal to 19, and that is equal to C1 at x equal to what? 1 by 10. 1 by 10 plus of, it is C2. This is one equation, that is in terms of C1 and C2. Then we will write this equation for the constants calculation. That is 1 by 10 and 2 by 100. So left side, that is 1 by 10. We will simplify this. This equation, that is 1 by 10 plus of, that is 2 by 100 into 90, that is 19 by 50, we can write, that is equal to 1 by 10 plus of, it is C2. Then you can multiply whole thing by 10, that is 1 plus of, that is 190, 19 into 10, 190. Otherwise, also you can write 10, multiplying by 10, 10 5s of this one, that is 19 by 5, then equal to, that is 1 plus of, sorry, that is C1 here, C1, that is C1 plus of 10, it is C2. Then you can take the LCM, 19 plus 5, it is 24 divided by 5 is equal to C1 plus 10 C2. Therefore, one equation C1 plus 10 C2, that is equal to 24 divided by 5. We have one equation by substituting one condition. Similarly, also at x equal to 1, y is equal to 1. Let us see what is this value comes to be. Then that comes to be x equal to 1 means 1 plus of 2 into 1, and y is also 1 equal to c1, x is 1 and plus of it is c2. Therefore, c1 plus c2, that is 1 plus 2 equal to 3, second equation. Then solving for c1 and solving for c1 and c2, we have solving for c1 and c2, we have, that is first equation, c1 plus 10 times c2 is equal to 24 divided by 5, and another equation, c1 plus c2, that is equal to 3. Now, first constant we can cancel by subtracting it. 10 minus 1, that is 9 c2 is equal to 24 by 5, and minus of 3, first term minus of second term we can take, that is 9 c2 from the left side and this much. So what is the answer? That is 5 3s of 15, that is 9 by 5 will be getting after simplification. Then 9 cancels with this, then c2 is equal to 1 by 5. This is one value. And from using the using one of the equations, putting c2 is equal to this value, calculated value, you can find out the another value of the constant. Therefore, c1 plus 1 by 5 is equal to 3. Then c1 is equal to 3 minus 1 by 5. Then the c1 is equal to 3 minus 1 by 5 is 5 is of 15, that is 14 divided by 5. Then the final equation, what we are getting, the final equation for the extremal, that is with the constants c1 and c2. Now the calculated values of c1 and c2 you have to write. So by putting at c1 is equal to, at c1 is equal to what value? That is c2 is equal to 1 by 5 and c1 is equal to 14 by 5. c1 is equal to 14 by 5 and c2 is equal to, that is 1 by 5. This implies x value as it is plus 2x square y is equal to 14 by 5 into x, and c2 plus of 1 by 5. Therefore, final form of extrema we are getting after taking the simplification. Therefore, here the equation is x plus of 2 times x square y equal to 14 divided by 5x plus of 1 by 5. But you have to write the equation y in terms of x. Let us simplify this equation, putting y in the left side and writing all the other terms on the another side. Therefore, 2x square y is equal to 14 by 5 x plus of 1 by 5 and minus of x is there. Then you can take the simplification between these two, that is 5x equal to 10x divided by 5 and plus of 1 by 5. This is 2x square. That should be y is there. So let us simplify finally, keeping only y is the left side, that is y is equal to 10 divided by 5 into 1 by 2 should be x divided by x square and plus 4, 1 divided by 5 into 1 divided by 2, that is x square is the denominator. Then what is the term you have to write? That is x square here, and the simplification you have to take from this last step. Okay, this is that is 5 2's are 2 5's are 10, this cancels. Therefore x divided by x square means 1 divided by x, 1 term plus so 1 divided by 10 into 1 by x square. This is y of x is the extremal. Y is a function of x, which is the required, which is the required extremal from the given functional. From the given functional. Like this, you can solve the problems, any number of problems, where when once function is identified, that function we have to take for the functional, and then Euler's equation you have to apply, and then arrange according to the Euler's equation with the condition that if y value or y term is not there, then you can take it is independent of y. So the next discussion in this topic is, that is variational problem in the calculus of variations. How this variational problem can be solved using calculus of variations? Let us try to understand what exactly this variational problem. And same once again, Euler's equation we have to apply, but the interpretation of the results will be in a different form. Okay. The next heading is variational problem. Variational problem for the given functional. It consists of determining, it consists of determining an extremal curve, that is y equal to y of x. Just now we have calculated this one, that is called extremal of the given functional. Y equal to y of x of a functional, functional I, by using the following conditions. Conditions or notations, you can say. That is first condition, that is delta I equal to delta integral a to b f of x comma y and y dash, that is dx equal to 0. And the second one, it satisfies the following, it satisfies the following boundary conditions. It satisfies the boundary conditions. What are those boundary conditions? First one is y of a equal to y1 implies y equal to y1 at x equal to a, and the second one, y of b is equal to y2 implies y equal to y2 at x equal to another point, that is b. This is the procedure to calculate variational problem, whatever that extremal is asked. Otherwise, we have to calculate the Euler's equation value of the functional, that is y is equal to y of x. Okay, I shall take the problem on this variational problem, how this procedure can be implemented in order to find the solution of the given variational problem. Let us see that. Example, solve the variational problem. Variational problem, that is delta integration, that is 0 to 1 y square plus x square, that is y dash, multiplied by dx, that is equal to 0 with the conditions y 0 is equal to 0 and y dash that is y of 1 is equal to 1. That means at x equal to a is 0, at x equal to b is this one, this is y1 and this is y2. Let us see how this problem can be solved at the end. The differential equation you are ready. That differential equation can be solved through Euler's equation. In the solution, let us take the problem with the functional, whatever it is given. Let delta I, according to the notation, it is delta, that is 0 to 1 integration under y square plus of x square y dash, that is dx. And the conditions are given. Y0 is equal to 0 implies this is y1, that means y at x is equal to a, that is y1, and y at 1 that is equal to 1 implies y at x equal to b, that is equal to y2. These are the notations. Next, by Euler's equation, we have, what is that differential equation? Del f divided by del y minus d by dx of del f divided by del y dash, and that's equal to 0. Del f by del y minus of d by dx, operating on del f by del y dash, that is equal to 0. Let us calculate these two derivatives, del f by del y and del f by del y dash, from the given functional. Now, from the given functional means, that is, given functional is this, that is f of this value. Of course, we have to separate this and then we have to take the differentiation of the given functional. Let f of x comma y comma y dash, that is equal to y square, first term is y square, plus of it is x square y dash, implies del f by del y, del f by del y is equal to 2y plus of, that is del f by del y is equal to 2y, that's all the first calculation, that is plus, of you can write it as 0, otherwise it is 2y only. Next, del f by del y dash, what is that value? Del f by del y dash, first term is 0 and the second term y dash is there. With respect to that y dash, you have to that is equal to, with respect to y dash, that is equal to x square only. Then, by Euler's equation, here we have to substitute these two values in the Euler's equation. By Euler's equation, we have, that is del f by del y means 2y minus d by dx, d by dx of, that is x square, that is equal to 0. After substituting these two, we have to solve this differential equation, that is d by dx derivative you have to write, and that comes to be first term as it is, that is 2y minus of 2x, and that's equal to 0. When it is equal to 0, we have to solve this differential equation, already it is a solution, but we have to take the interpretation of this solution, whatever we have obtained from Euler's equation.
You can cancel 2, and then this is y minus x equal to 0. This indicates what is the extremal, that is y is equal to x. That means y of x is equal to x is there. What is the meaning of this? Y equal to x, it is nothing but straight line passing through the origin. It is a homogeneous equation and it is a straight line passing through the origin. Then this equation denotes a straight line which gives the extremal of the variational problem. That itself is the extremal we can consider, which is the extremal, which is the extremal of the given functional. Further, what is the procedure? We have to verify the given conditions. How those conditions are to be verified? Those conditions you have to put at x equal to 1, what is the value of y, at x equal to 0, what is the value of y. Then both the conditions are to be satisfied. Let us verify these conditions, how they will satisfy. The first condition, at y0 is equal to 0, it is given, the first condition is, so that y equal to x is our equation, implies 0 is equal to 0, one condition satisfied. At second condition, y of 1 is equal to 1, that means left side is 1 and right side is 1, and this is also satisfied. That means both the conditions, given conditions, are satisfied. Hence, this function can be accepted as extremal of the given function. Let us see another problem of different variety to solve the variational problem. Then, how this variational problem, another problem behaves, to find out the extremal, whatever the conditions are given, we will make use of those conditions to find out the extremal. Let me take another example. Yes. Solve the variational problem. Solve the variational problem, that is delta integration 1 to 2 x square, it is y dash square plus 2y into x plus y, this is dx, that is equal to 0, with the conditions y1 equal to 0 and y2 is also 0. Same time, let us try how this equation gives us the solution. We have to identify the function and then we have to apply Euler's equation
and then if differential equation comes, then we have to solve the differential equation, then we have to make use of these two conditions in the solution. Let f of x comma y comma, that is y dash, that is equal to x square y dash x square plus some 2y into x plus y is there. Let us take this one as expanded form. That expanded form will be x square y dash square plus some 2xy plus some 2 times it is y square. This is the value of f. Now, by Euler's equation, we have, del f y, del y. At this time, by Euler's equation, we have this, the equation is del f y, del y minus d by dx, del f by del y dash, that is equal to 0. Then del f by del y means with respect to y, first term is 0, second term that gives us 2x, and next term is plus of, that is with respect to y means 4y. This is one value. And another value, del f by, it is del y dash, that is equal to, with respect to y dash means 2 times x square, that is into y dash. So del f by del y dash is equal to 2 times x square y dash, and both the values will substitute in Euler's equation. Then from Euler's equation, what we have from Euler's equation, we have to substitute these two values. Then 2x, that is in place of del f by del y, 2x plus 4y and minus of d by dx of, that is 2x square y dash, that is equal to 0. Here it is not the case of the first derivative, it is independent of y, because y term is given and it is also appeared in the given functional. Then we have to differentiate this one, that means d by dx is there, and we have to differentiate this one with respect to x, and further what is the differentiation and then how the terms will fall, let us verify what kind of final form of the equation we are getting and what kind of solution we have to solve for that. That is 2x. First term is 2x plus some 4y, 2x plus 4y and d by dx. So we have to find out d by dx, that is here with respect to x you are doing, with respect to x means that is 2x, and plus of another term, that is y double dash you are getting. Okay, minus, that is d by dx with respect to x, this is a product of two terms. Therefore, 4x into y dash, one term, minus sign as is, 2x square, that is into y double dash, that is equal to 0, because y dash is equal to dy by dx. Then d by dx of y dash is equal to d square y divided by, it is dx square. Then dx square means this can be taken as y double dash and this is already taken as y dash. Now we will write in the decreasing order of the derivative, that is y double dash term first I will write, minus of 2x square y double dash, and y dash is one term, 4x into, it is y dash, and this one y term I will keep in the left side, plus 4y, and that is equal to minus of, it is 2x. I am sending this 2x to the another side. Then minus 2 I will cancel here, that is with 2 times with minus 2, that is x square and y double dash. This is minus of minus 2x means plus sign comes, and here it is 2x into y dash, and minus of this must be 2y is equal to x. So this is the differential equation we got finally. And what kind of this differential equation is? This is called differential equation with variable coefficients. This is not a differential equation with constant coefficients, but variable coefficients. In the case of variable coefficients, we have to reduce it to the differential equation with constant coefficients, and then we have to solve. Now we can declare this differential equation as derivative with variable coefficients. What are those variable coefficients? X square for the second order derivative and x to the first order derivative. How this solution will be obtained from this differential equation? Let us see that. That is x square, we can call it as, which is the differential equation, which is the differential equation with variable coefficients. With variable coefficients. Then, what is the procedure to reduce it to this one? We have to avoid this x square here and we have to avoid this x here by choosing what is that value. You have to choose x in terms of some other symbol. What is that x in terms of some other symbol? Either in terms of t with exponential as a base, otherwise in terms of some z you can take. Then put x equal to e to the power z, which implies x into y dash, that is equal to dy dy, where y is a function of y of z. That means x into y dash, and x square into y double dash can be taken as, that is d into d minus 1, that is y. So this is a Cauchy's differential equation. Already you might have discussed in differential equation with constant coefficients and variable coefficients, and directly I am writing by the substitution. This makes a product of variable with first order derivative as dy, and product of variable square with second order derivative multiplication as d into d minus of y, where y is a function of z. Therefore, the given differential equation will be reduced to what kind? So this must be d into, it is d minus 1, that is y, plus of 2 into, that is dy minus 2y, this is equal to x. That is equal to x, but x is equal to what value? That is e to the power z. So we can call this differential equation, that is simplifying like this, d square minus d plus of 2d minus 2 operating on y is equal to e to the power z. It means this differential equation was in terms of x and y. Now this differential equation is in terms of z and y. So it is the differential equation with the constant coefficients. There is no variable here appeared. That is all the derivatives, first order and second order derivatives, are multiplied by constant coefficients, so that it is called as Cauchy's differential equation. Then further simplification will give us d square minus d plus 2d gives us plus d, and minus of 2, this gives, that is y is equal to e to the power z. This is nothing but f of d, y operating on, that is z of z you can take. That means even r of z you can take. It is a function of z. This is a standard notation where you can compare, that is function of d. So that the solution we have, solution will be a linear combination of complementary function plus particular
integral.
How this solution will behave? Let us verify this one. Then the solution is given by y is equal to yc plus yp, where yc, what is it called? Complementary function. Complementary function, and yp is particular integral. Particular integral. What is this complementary function? Means
it is a solution for the LHS of that problem which is reduced to the constant coefficient. That means differential equation reduced to the constant coefficients.
Let us see that how this solution will be got. What is the complementary function? It needs writing of this derivative in terms of auxiliary form. That auxiliary form we can have. What are the values of these coefficients? That is b square. The equation is b square plus b minus 2 operating on y is equal to e to the power z. So yc refers to solution for the LHS and yp refers to particular integral with reference to the RHS of the problem. So let the auxiliary equation v, that is m square minus that is plus m minus 2 equal to 0. M is equal to, that is 1 comma, m is equal to 1 comma minus 2. That implies yc is equal to c1 e to the power, it is in terms of z, c1 e to the power z plus of c2 e to the power minus of, it is 2z. This is called complementary function. And yp, by inverse differential operator we can calculate, yp is equal to 1 divided by, it is b square plus d and minus 2, that is e to the power z, it is to be operated on this. Then what we do here, we replace this d by the coefficient of z, it is equal to 1 divided by 1 square plus 1 and minus of 2, that is operating on e to the power z, that is multiplied. This is equal to 1 divided by, it is 2 minus 2 and e to the power z we have. But this becomes 1 divided by 0 e to the power z, and for this type what we call, this is a case of failure of that particular step. Then we can consider the differentiation with respect to d. This is the case of failure. This is the case of failure. Then yp is equal to 1 divided by, we take the differentiation, 2d plus of 1 operating on what value? That is e to the power z. Then you replace this, but it should be multiplied by z. Whenever we differentiate outside, it must be multiplied by z. Then z into that is z coefficient here is 1, that is 1 divided by 2 into 1 plus of, that is 1, to be multiplied to e to the power z. So z divided by 3 into e to the power z, this is yp. Then what you have to do in the next step, that is yp is equal to z by 3 e to the power z, therefore solution is given by y is equal to c1 e to the power z plus c2 e to the power minus 2z then plus of z by 3 e to the power z is that. This is not a complete solution. Once again, it includes the constants c1 and c2. We must find out these constants from the given conditions. That is, two conditions are given, y1 equal to 0 and y2 is equal to 0. Then let us use these conditions in the same type, whatever they are given, and then we will find out the actual values. Okay. Now, at y1, that is equal to 0, then y1 equal to 0 means left side 0 we have to take, and c1 e to the power 1, that is 1 you can take, at z equal to 1, sorry, this is y1 equal to 0 means you have to express, because this z is new symbol we have taken, but you have to express this problem in terms of the original symbol. What is that? That is equal to c1 e to the power, that is z was taken as x was taken as e to the power z, then z is equal to log of x, on both sides log x, log you are applying, log e to the power z is nothing but z only, therefore z equal to log x, then e to the power log x and plus of c2 e to the power minus of 2 times it is log x and plus of log x and e to the power log x and divided by 3. Before that, the simplification comes to be like this, e to the power log x is, that is c1 into x, and the second term, that is x to the power minus 2, that is plus of c2 into 1 divided by x square, that comes to the denominator, and plus of log x e to the power log x means x into log x divided by, it is 3. This is the extremal, which is represented as an equation as a solution combination of yc and yp. Okay, so this part I will continue in the next discussion. Up to this session, we can go through all these details, how this Euler's equation is going to be applied.